Morning guys, welcome back to the channel. So it's currently about 7:15. We're in Montpellier and we're heading back to Nice today. So it's a 6-hour coach journey, and so we'll be getting the coach at about 8, and I think we're getting back at about 2 roughly, if all goes to plan. And then hopefully we are going to Phil Neville's press conference this evening ahead of the England and Japan game, which is tomorrow night. So exciting times. I probably will sleep on the journey home because I'm shattered. But yeah, so I'm going to take you guys with me. I hope you enjoy this vlog, and let's go. So we're now back in Nice. We've just got off the coach. It took 6 hours to get back, so I'm really tired now. I had a bit of a disaster, so the bus stopped off at the service station and our lecturer got off for a drink or whatever, and basically the bus then set off without him. We told the bus to stop and it wouldn't, so I think he might be getting the train back, I'm really not sure, but there's only 4 of us returned and 5 of us left here yesterday, so that's not great, but it is what it is, and I'm sure we'll get back today anyways. But yeah, so we're heading back to the hotel now with our stuff, and then we've got the press conference later on today, so that's it really. The weather's really nice here, and I'll keep you up to date with the rest of the day. So it's 3 o'clock, I've just come out of the supermarket, I've gone and got myself some dinner. I'm heading back to the hotel now, and I'm going to be writing a piece this afternoon, and then I'm going to be going to Phil Neville's press conference this evening. So busy day ahead, but I'm very excited. I'm hungry now, so I need food. Sun's shining, I'm not complaining about anything, you know. So yeah, let's go. Obviously England take on Japan, very big game. Obviously England want to top the group and want to finish first. Phil Neville's made that very clear in his press conference, he wants them to finish first. So Lucy Bronze has said, I motivate myself to be the best. She was asked how it feels when Phil Neville describes her as one of the best in the world and admits she tells him he's wrong. So indefinitely doesn't add extra pressure. I motivate myself to be the best player I can be. It's not just me, there's a lot of players he believes in. It comes from him believing in us and the team. So obviously Lucy Bronze did sit alongside Phil Neville in the press conference today. And then when asked about trying to avoid France or USA in the semi-final, which is actually a very good question, Neville said, no, not really. We've got a long way to go. That fixture excites probably us both. We've not looked beyond tomorrow night, to be honest with you. And there are pitfalls to finishing first and second. My view is we want to win 7 games in this World Cup, so it doesn't matter which route we take. We're going out to try and win the game with our strongest team, with a performance like we've seen in the last 2 games. So that was what he said about, obviously, France or USA in the semi-final. And then someone mentioned, have you been reading up on the VAR rules? And Neville said the penalty last night wasn't a grey area for anyone who's read up on the rules. As soon as it happened, that was a penalty, so VAR is getting it right. So he basically said they are rules and they'll be adhered to pretty much. And then it was mentioned about people underestimating the quality of the 2015 team, and Phil Neville had a really strong opinion on that. He said people underestimate the quality of that 2015 team. They go to the semi-final of the World Cup. They got to the semi-final of the World Cup. You look back to the picture of that team celebrating that third place, you've got world-class players. So he highlighted how good that team was when people possibly undermined them. So that was really nice to see. And then also, if my laptop will work, what was the impact of the 2015 semi-final defeat was mentioned. And Bron said, I think both on a personal level and collectively, it leaves you more hungry. We got knocked out of the World Cup in Euros in the semi-finals, so no one is as hungry as we are to get to a final. Absolutely, I think we're very silly to underestimate Japan. That was pretty much everything that was said in the press conference today. They know it's going to be a difficult game, but they want to finish top. And yes, that's what Phil Neville said in his press conference. That's some of the points, anyways, and what Lucy Bron said. But they made it clear that they want to win tomorrow night. Phil Neville's going to play a stronger side. And they want to finish top, you know. I think they're not looking too far past that point, obviously. There's talks of them coming up against France and USA. I think all Phil's focused on is making sure that that team wins tomorrow night. And thank you guys, and that's what all that was said in the press conference.
We might go in two lots.
So guys, I'm back at the hotel now. I've just got back from Phil Neville's press conference. It was really good. I really enjoyed it. I've literally just went to get myself a takeaway, so I'm eating that now. And I'm all ready for tomorrow's game. I'm sorry that this vlog is quite short today, but it has pretty much just been travelling back, you know. It was a 6-hour journey, and then I did a bit of work when I come back, went for food and stuff. So not loads has gone on today, but as I said, it was a 6-hour journey back, so that took up most of the day, you know. Tomorrow's going to be a match day vlog, so that's really exciting. I can't wait for tomorrow. And stay tuned for tomorrow's vlog. I will be doing this vlog in like 2 days, joined together again. So stay tuned, and I'll see you all in the morning. Welcome back to the channel. This is vlog 14, day 14. I can't believe that we've managed to keep these vlogs going every single day. Like, that's great. It's crazy. I'm buzzing. I'm really excited today. It's game day. It's England versus Japan. I've got a buzzing vibe about me today, you know? Like, this game's so exciting. It's going to be a good one. And I'm so ready for it. Now, it's at 9 o'clock tonight. It's France time. So today I'm going to do some prep work. I've got an article to write for the Chelsea Echo as well. I'm going to have some dinner. And, yeah, it's going to be a productive day, I hope. But yeah, as I said, so I'm going to be doing two match reports tonight for two different outlets. So it's going to be testing, it's going to be pushing me out of my comfort zone, but I'm raring and ready to go for it, you know. I feel like sometimes the best thing to do when you maybe not confident at something is to just push yourself out of your comfort zone, give it your all, and that's exactly what I'm going to do with these match reports tonight. I'm going to give it my best. I'm also going to try and get fan opinions before the game. It's going to be a very, very busy evening, but I'm ready for it. I will be, as I said, having dinner at about 12 or something, because last time I went to the game, I didn't actually have any tea because I was too busy doing work and stuff. And I come back at about 2 a.m. and without any food, which was not good. So I'm not letting that happen today. We're going to have a big meltdown time. So that's planned for today. I hope you enjoy this vlog. I'm excited. I'm buzzing. I'm going to get on with some work now, and I need to stop talking on here because I've got loads to do. I hope you enjoy this vlog. I hope you enjoyed yesterday's. It's gonna be a good day. You guys can come with me. Let's go. So it's now 2:40 in the afternoon. I've done my prep work, I've had some food, about to go for a shower, and then I'll be ready for the game, you know. I'm really excited now. We are setting off at around 5, so I'm getting ready, and then we're good to go, and then we're going to England versus Japan. So it's very exciting. Can't wait to get there now. I've got them pretty much vibes, you know. Exciting times. So we're here at the Stade de Nice now for England versus Japan. We're all ready. It's 3 hours from kickoff roughly, so a bit of time, but I'm sure the fans will start gathering very shortly. I'll try and get some fan opinions as well. The stadium is looking lovely. All sunny out here in France. Let's go. Okay guys, I'm outside the ground with two England fans. So would you both like to introduce yourself and give your pre-match thoughts and score predictions for today's game?
I think England team.
travelled for today's game?
We live here, so we don't travel.
Oh no, that's amazing. Thank you both so much for coming on and enjoying the game. So guys, I'm outside the stadium and these two fans are supporting England today. So would you both like to introduce yourselves and say how far you travelled for today's game?
I'm Laurie Key. I used to live in Hanoi, Vietnam.
Oh, amazing.
Okay, my name's Ian Food and I'm originally from England, but I haven't lived there for over 30 years. I live and work in South Korea. But we're actually here on holiday, so we've driven from the other side of France for about 8 hours to get here.
That's absolutely wonderful. Mm. It's lovely to see both supporting the women's game.
Mm. Yeah.
So what are your pre-match thoughts for today's game?
You go ahead.
Oh, you know, I think England's going to win.
Yeah.
How's that?
Okay. Well, you know, I kind of have split loyalties because I've been to Japan and I love the country.
Yeah.
So we have a soft spot in our hearts for the Japanese.
We do.
And of course, I like Japan, but I love England. So
yeah.
I'm gonna go for England.
Yeah.
I think it's gonna be close though.
We'll have divided loyalties if when the US play the UK though.
Definitely.
The US play England. England.
Yeah.
England.
And what are your final score predictions for today's game?
I think it's gonna be 3-2 to England.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll go with that.
3-2.
Yeah. 3-2.
What do you think?
I don't think it's going to be that high. I think it's going to be 1-2.
Yeah.
I just hope it's going to be a high scoring and exciting game.
Yes. Yeah, definitely. I'm sure it will be. Yeah. Thank you both so much for coming on.
Yeah, thanks for inviting
us.
Thank
you. All right. So guys, I'm with two England fans outside the stadium. So would you both like to introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Simon.
Hi, my daughter.
Hi. So, what are your pre-match thoughts for today's game?
England will win, definitely.
Yeah. And how are you feeling about Tony Duggan potentially being back in the lineup this evening?
Yeah, very excited.
Yeah. And what's your final score predictions for tonight's game? Do you think England are going to win?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
I think 2-0.
I think 2-0.
Yeah, love that. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So it's 2:30 in the morning and I've just got back. It's been a great day. It was great to get fan opinions on the vlog. I've done two match reports, one with just like from the match on the whistle and then one with integrated quotes. And one of them's been published on FAWSL and that is on my Twitter if you guys want to check that out if you want. And then another one might be published by another outlet, but I'll let you guys know. You guys might be already know this from my social media and stuff, but Georgia Stanway is from Barrow and that's about 1.5 hours away from me because obviously I go to Derby Uni, but I'm originally from Cumbria, that's where my roots are. So I have got pieces to write about Georgia Stanway for outlets around me in my local area, hopefully. So I'm getting that sorted out and that'll be tomorrow's job. But something massive happened for me tonight. I don't want to go on about it, but for me, it's a massive achievement. So, in Phil Neville's press conference, I asked her a question, and that's a big deal for me. I've never ever asked a question in a press conference in my life before. I've never. And to do it, and at a Women's World Cup game after England just won 2-0, is a massive achievement for me. I feel really proud. Unfortunately, I can't enter it into this vlog because of copyright and stuff, but I can leave a link down in the description below and for the actual YouTube video, so I'll put the minutes on that. I asked my question and you guys can watch it if you want, but that was a massive achievement for me. I know I don't look that enthusiastic about it because I'm absolutely shattered and I've hardly had much sleep recently, but yeah, I'm just absolutely made up. And as I said, I don't look enthusiastic about it, but I really was at the time. I was shaking, I was like nervous to ask a question, but I did it and I'm really proud of myself. Phil Neville gave a massive answer to the question as well, which was a big deal, and he was smiling and all sorts, and when he was from Cumbria, he was smiling. It was just great. So that is one of the biggest highlights of the trip for me, for sure. Like, this trip's been amazing. I've enjoyed every experience. Everything's been amazing. It hasn't finished yet. I've got another game coming up, so that's really exciting too. Another exciting day tomorrow. But that has got to be the highlight of my trip, just for many different reasons. And yeah, it just kind of rounds off how this trip's gone for me, you know. Like, I feel like I've made a lot of progress. And that was just kind of like tip tips that cut off the iceberg, if that makes sense. It's just finished it off perfectly. But we've got more work to do in the next couple of days. It's going to be busy, and I'm really excited for that, to work hard and go till the very end. I want to keep trying to get as much work published as I can. I'm enjoying the football a lot. It's been great. Thank you for tuning in, guys. I hope you enjoyed this vlog. I'm not going to ramble on anymore because you're probably sick of hearing my voice now. I'll see you all in tomorrow's vlog. Tomorrow's exciting. I'll tell you all about that in tomorrow's vlog. For now, good night.